Hey guys, Correspondent Tutor here. Welcome to a little game called That Dragon Cancer. Now, from what I know, from what I've seen other YouTubers play of this, and what I've seen from just the description, this is about a little boy. This is a true story about a little boy who passed from cancer. I personally, I know everyone probably has someone in their lives that has passed from some sort of cancer or disease or something. My uncle Brian died from several different stages of cancer, but let's get into the game and see how it goes. Down the volume a bit. Sorry, sensitivity is a little high.
He doesn't understand. Here you go, Joel. Here's a piece. Okay, now you try.
You're almost five, right?
Yeah.
But he can't talk.
It's true.
Yeah.
He can talk.
Yeah, I know.
Why can't Joel?
Yeah, just real quick, guys. This is a game to do with the passing of a little boy, to do with cancer, having passed from cancer. Just a warning, if you guys are triggered by that, if you guys have lost someone, this may not be the best video for you. This video will, if goes up on YouTube, most likely be age-restricted, or just, it will have a warning beforehand and in the description just saying, just be careful watching this if you have trouble dealing with death or people who have passed due to cancer or who passed, just people who have passed due to anything really, but you can't even see my face when I'm looking at the camera, but yeah, just heads up, this is a game to do with cancer, and viewer discretion is advised.
Joel got sick right after he turned one.
Kind of slowed him down a little bit, buddy.
Yeah. So he's just slower than most kids. I think eventually he'll catch up. Yeah, I think Joel will read eventually.
Well, of course, he's just the right
because, you know.
Yeah.
You're supposed to be a boy, but he's a baby. He's a boy baby.
Yeah, he's a boy baby. That's just about right. You know, there's lots of things Joel isn't good at, but there's some things he is good at. What is he good at?
Eating, laughing.
Yeah.
We're good at making him laugh.
You are good at making him laugh. Why? How do you make him laugh?
I fall down.
Yeah. It's really funny when you fall down.
He's good at doing his boy loves.
Yeah.
I don't know, this game does get pretty heavy the more it goes on, so.
What does Joel love? Wawa. In cups, bathtubs. And the warm, wet tongues and the cool fur stars. And maybe this one was a daily affection. And bye-byes. And blown kisses. And more. Oh, always more. This full list of words. So few.
Sorry, 1 second. I'm turning down the volume for myself. It's a little loud in my ear. I want to think that for those who believe in a higher power, I want to think that that's who was talking.
Ooh.
Cute little kid. Here's kind of where the, yeah, just warning you now, from what I've seen from other people playing this, it does get, this is kind of where it starts ramping up in the, hard to watch parts, so, just letting people know, just letting parents know if they're watching this with their kids, if they're, watching it alone, or again, if you have difficulty, just this is kind of where it starts getting harder.
Fear is cancer's preservative, cancer's embalming oil. And you, O accuser, are fear's oil sales. You're a snake, a serpent, a dragon with snuffed out colon, his breath molten, talons broken from the struggle to free yourself of your own skin.
We kind of are going into a hospital right now, so just be forewarned, ladies and gentlemen watching this. Ah. I accidentally clicked out of the game. Sorry again that I'm playing this, I felt like in my personal life it was a good time to play this, because my uncle who died from cancer, his birthday was yesterday, so. I wasn't able to play it yesterday, so I felt like today was a better day to play it. I think I'm falling asleep. Thank you. Sorry, there's a fly flying around here. I accidentally clicked out of the game again. I keep clicking out of the game, I'm sorry. Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, I'm okay. Excuse me. Oh. Well, my Twitch. Twitch just got lost. Hi Twitch, I'm back. Sorry, I don't know why it's cutting in and out. I assume that all these photos have to do with people or their children who have died or have passed from cancer or something along those lines. I assume that's mom. It's a cow. Oh, those are like meds that I assume people with cancer have to take.
Did anyone ask the doctor?
Okay, is it
There's a part later in the game I know of that... that hurts a lot more. Oh, son of a biscuit. Hey, Joel. There's a part later where there's like cards in the hallway that part gets real rough. Okay. Oh, that's a fun game. I touch it and the lion comes? Sure, I'll hear you. Oh, that's scary. Got the book. This is the part where I was talking about the letters all over the hospital, so viewer discretion advised for this part. This part is hard because I'm 10 years old. Hugs to all my UIHC kids and families, Greg Rice. To my hero, Henry M. Now, I'm not going to go through all of them because there's just so many of them, but each one has its own story and is its own person. To everyone who's ever died of cancer, especially my father and grandmother, rest in peace, Hank, Marcia, and all the rest of you beautiful, beautiful people. I hope that whatever's become of you, you are presently better off than you were at the end of your life. We miss you. There's just so fucking many. For my brother Kyle. I'm gonna be terrible pronouncing that, so I'm not even gonna try, I'm sorry. For Lucky Lou, stay strong and keep fighting. I wish I had the time today to stay and read each and every one of these. There is nothing more resilient than the human heart. Oh, we'll do one more. Daniel Hyung Lee. It is. I'm sorry, guys. It's not good. Thank you. It's an impressive horse. That is one smart horse. Go to the mob now.
I'm going to cry after all because they love us. And they love Joel. And we're very good at managing the pain and that.
I said fatal. I said not curative. Have I said the word death yet? I can tell they understand, though. A whole new vocabulary. All the rules are different now. I think it's really sinking in. Oh, she's crying. We should wrap this up soon. All the details can wait. I'll just decide whether we can do some radiation or just chemotherapy. Well, the radiation could probably cure the tumor we see now, which would prevent it from causing any symptoms. But it would not keep more tumors from developing, because we know if it's spread here, it would spread other places too. Science, it's simpler. Result, and I can do something to control, or at least have the sense that I'm controlling. All we have left is a miracle, and miracles are fickle. They don't always come, and we don't always know why. If Joel's miracle doesn't come, I hope he lives. I always hope. Now I can't do anything. Radiation. At least we can do something. Hope doesn't require signing papers or driving to hospitals or holding Joel in my lap. Hope is for something someone else has to do for us. And when doctors can't. That's what Jesus wants.
We're so
God, I do not want a replacement baby. If that was your plan, I am not on board. I don't want some new baby to help me move on. I would not have chosen them. Oh, God. Joel has to live, or I will not love this baby.
I'm sorry, guys. It's not good.
Am I right?
Sorry, I'm not commentating much. I just... These types of games are hard, you know? Are hard to commentate over. Oh, my ankle.
I have so many things stirring around in my spirit that I have to write.
I have so many things stirring around in my spirit that I have to write to settle myself and find God's wisdom in the midst of chaos. I am scared I won't be strong enough to feel the things we must have to face in the coming weeks and months. But then I remember how much grace God gave us to walk out everything we have already faced. Sorry, I can't read cursive too well. So no matter what comes next, and I truly cannot even begin to guess how this will go, and now we will be carried. I want to shout out, look what God is about to do. Watch how he delivers Joel. And at the same time, I want to roll up in a silent ball and wait it out with the fear and... Hey, I didn't read it all. I'm sorry. Again, I'm sorry, guys, that this is a hard video. I still have one of these old, like, cassette CD player type things. My mouse is on my second monitor, so if I just click out of the game, I apologize.
Sometimes. You know what she wrote on the eve of Joel's first surgery? The one. there because self-inspection leads me to conclude I shouldn't expect much of anything. And yet my wife is expecting a surprise party from the Lord. Complete presence, supernatural miracle.
Okay. This is the story of a very brave knight named Joel.
Joel the baby one?
Yes. Joel the baby knight. He's also Joel the very brave knight. And he is being chased.
Because of the storm?
Mm-hmm.
Where does the dragon live?
In a forest.
Is the dragon big?
Very.
Does the dragon use fire?
I push down, but it doesn't. Sometimes it's too high, or it's too low to.
Yeah, that sounds good. So brave Sir Joel, with his sword and his shield and his awesome spear and.
Superpowers
does
he have?
He also has legs.
That's not a superpower.
It's the best superpower.
Oh, a verb is coming to help me up.
Just when he thought that the danger was past, the dragon found his hiding spot and came after him in the cave.
That dragon's going to kill you. It's only going to lose.
Why do you say that?
Because it's just a big thing. You can't kill dragon.
Tim fought so well. He's so great, so strong. God let him rest. It may have seemed like the dragon was in the past. I know that Tim's in heaven.
I don't know if I'm supposed to let the dragon win, or...
Despair doesn't help anything.
You're right, the dragon lost. Tim won. You're right.
How can you say false hope? You're drowning!
Well, you're missing your oars! And you don't even know where you're going. And yet you're so sure you're gonna get there.
It's better than drowning.
Enjoy floating on the surface. You have to let me feel this! Someone has to.
That's not fair. I love him as much as you do. I just really believe we're going to be okay.
Oh. I'm sure my expectation looks... I'm not gonna read it because I'm fucking up the words. Sorry. Come on, swim up. Swim up to the surface. You got this, man. How I understand it, it's like a depression drown type of thing. Yeah. I don't know why I just keep repeating this. Well, I do know why. I do know why. I'm not gonna say I don't know why. I do know why, but... Am I supposed to make him go deeper? Yes, I am. Oh, I'm supposed to go to the window.
I hate this room. I didn't used to. For a moment, it was an adventure. I was cast as the compassionate and caring father, holed up with his fragile son in a small cleft in the rocks. The storm raging, waves ripping at the sharp black rocks below, and enveloped in my arms, he feels safe, and I am holding him firmly, trying not to slip. But if you hold tight enough, nothing will take him. Right?
I'm sorry, I can't, my... I need to up the sensitivity again. It was just really bad with the duck. Oh, that's so much better. sorry. Oh, I just did this part, I'm sorry. The bathroom's flooding.
Hungry. I wonder if he's hungry. He's screaming louder. Buddy, don't you want juice? He hits the box. He don't catch it. Buddy, but you'll throw it up. Don't grab too hard. You'll squirt all the juice out. Here, let me have it. It's so late, Joel. Lay down. I can't hold you. I can't make you feel better. Okay, buddy, okay, I'll hold you.
I'm sorry if this...
Oh, Joel, bud. You look so miserable. No! Don't hit your head on the bars, Joel. Joel! I know you're mad. Please stop.
I'm sorry if this video has made any of you cry, or... I'm sorry.
There's a story in the Bible where Jesus and his disciples are on a boat. And a furious storm hits the sea, and everyone thinks they're gonna die. Where do you think Jesus is? Rowing alongside them? He's asleep. In the back of the boat. So his disciples are freaking out and wake him up and they say, "Don't you care if we drown?" So Jesus gets up and he says to the storm, "Quiet, be still." And the sea becomes completely calm. why they are so scared, and if they have any faith at all. Like he was frustrated with them. Because even though Jesus said, let's go to the other side of the lake, his disciples thought he was going to just let them die. Die with Jesus even care? Will he weep for him as he did for Lazarus? Will he weep for me? I think greater than my fear of death is that of insignificance. Rather, my default assumption is that my thoughts and passions and loves and the stuff of my being are insignificant. How could the creator of all that is and ever was love my son as he did Lazarus? And could my soul stranded on this blue raft, awash in a sea of stars, ice, and dust, matter enough to him to turn his hand in mercy?
We both end up in the same place. We always do. That just scares me every time. I just really believe he'll be healed. I know you believe too, just when you act like that, I get all unsure.
I don't know that.
What do you mean?
Sorry, there's a fly around, that's why I keep doing that. Sorry, 1 second. I'm trying to... 1 second.
Without his laugh, and yet our hearts are still full, but with a different drink. And this ride we've been on for so long is silent, so also the love. And so we sit here in this new silence, and long for the music to start again, and for the disc to spin again, even if it means going round and round for many more years. For at least we would be moving, and Joel would be laughing here on Earth. His silence is only because he is drawn this way. And now we know love and longing, empty and full, all in one. And I am grateful that we loved him and that we miss him now. And I hope that in the Lord's next breath, he will whisper his love song to me. And that you will know him differently and more deeply.
Thank you guys so very much for tuning in and coming out to... I agree. Thank you guys so much for coming out and going in experiencing this game with me. I'm so sorry that if I had made any of you depressed or sad during this video, but I felt it was the right thing to do for kind of in the memory of my Uncle Brian. I'm so sorry if any of you have ever had to experience a loved one passing due to cancer or any type of disease or something, or illness. This all takes me back to when I would visit my Uncle Brian in the hospital, and when I myself was in the hospital, not for cancer, but for my brain injury, and when my grandparents were in the hospital when they had cancer, but luckily they did beat it, but my uncle wasn't so lucky. Thank you guys so very much for watching this. If you're with loved ones, if you're near loved ones, go hug and be with your loved ones. Stop watching this video, stop watching this stream, wherever you're watching it. Go be with your family, go be with your friends, go be with your loved ones. You never know when the last time you'll be with them might be. I turned off my webcam because I felt it was the right thing to do. I felt the game had more precedence over seeing my face in the top corner. So, thank you guys so much for watching. Go be with your friends. Go be with your family. Hug them. Love them. Take care of them. Make sure that they know that you love them. Make sure that they know that you care about them and that they are really important to you. I'm gonna let this play out and then I'll be going myself to go spend some time with loved ones. Thank you guys again so much for tuning in and being here to experience this with me. Each and every one of you, whether you're a Twitch supporter or a YouTube subscriber, just know that I love you, and I'm so thankful that you guys are here to support me or just to be with me and watch the stupid, sometimes, most of the time stupid and sometimes funny stuff that I upload and other times serious stuff. Thank you guys so much for watching. Go be with your loved ones. Go be with your family. Go be with your friends. Make sure that they know that you love them. Make sure that they know no matter what happens, you will do your best to be there for them. I love you guys. And I'll see you guys later. I'll see you guys in the next stream or video. Have a wonderful rest of your night, guys. Or the wonderful rest of whatever time of day it is that you're watching this, and just spend some time with the people you love. So long, guys.